read Judges 13.
Vathuri 13.
You can go home and read Judges 13 from 1 to 17.
From 1 to 17.
But we won't read the whole of it. Just read, Mama, from verse 1.
From verse 1.
Judges 13.
Now Israel again did what was evil in the sight of the Lord, and the Lord gave them into the hands of the Philistine for 40 years. And there was a certain man of Zorah of the family of the Danites, whose name was Manoah. And his wife was infertile and had no children. And the angel of the Lord appeared to the woman and said to her, "Behold, you are infertile and have no children, but you shall conceive and give birth to a son. Therefore, be careful not to drink wine or any other intoxicating drink, and do not drink anything ceremonially unclean. For behold, you shall conceive and give birth to a son. No razor shall come upon his head, for the boy shall be a Nazarite, dedicated to God from birth. And he shall begin to rescue Israel from the hands of the Philistines." Then the woman went and told her husband, saying, "A man of God came to me, and his appearance was like the appearance of the angel of God, very awesome. I did not ask him where he came from, and he did not tell me his name. But he said to me, 'Behold, you shall conceive and give birth to a son. And now you shall not drink wine or any other intoxicating drink, nor eat anything ceremonially unclean. For the boy shall be a Nazarite to God from birth to the day of his death.' Then Manoah pleaded with the Lord and said, 'O Lord, please let the man of God whom you sent come again to us and teach us what we are to do for the boy who is to be born.' And God listened to the voice of Manoah, and the angel of God came again to the woman, and she sat in the field, but Manoah's husband was not with her. So the woman ran quickly and told her husband, 'Behold, the man who came to me the other day has appeared to me.' Then Manoah got up and followed his wife and came to the man and said to him, 'Are you the man who spoke to this woman?' He said, 'I am.' And Manoah said, 'Now, when your words come true, what shall be the boy's manner of life and his vocation?' The angel of the Lord said to Manoah, 'The woman must pay attention to everything that I said to her. She may not eat anything that comes from the vine, nor drink wine or any other intoxicating drink, nor eat anything ceremonially unclean. She shall observe everything that I command her.'"
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to look at this story. I was reading this story this morning. I found that this is a story that shows that God does visit to us without knowing. I want to tell you why God is not visiting us. Just write, "Judge not." Write, "Judge not." If you can see, the story of Manoah and his wife,
Tabaya Manoah le msadi hai,
you realize that already it was long time overdue for them to have a baby.
Le tla bona re tabaya bona ya re ba ka taba ba le ngwana na ise tshi tsa maile fitile.
And in their lives,
ene maphilonga bona,
they might have found some people who told them,
ba ka ba ona le batho ba ile ba thaloseitsa,
that this will happen, that will happen. But you could see the approach that the wife faced from this
man.
You could see that to Manoah, he never judged his wife. You could understand that Manoah was always be in a position of expectant. What Manoa was looking at, whoever speak positive, Manoa will say amen. If you want to see that Manoa could not judge anybody, you could understand when the wife come and say, there was a man of God. This man having a countenance like an angel from God. Manoa was having right to say, my wife now, she's trying to defend herself. The message that the wife of Manoa got was supposed to have reached to Manoa, and Manoa was supposed to have judged his wife in a wrong way. If you can see, you will see Manoa saying, it's better I seek God concerning what you are saying. And he prayed that this angel must come back. And if you can also see, you realize that when the angel came back, was not coming with the wings. There was no sign that this man was from above. But when he came there, he was so normal, as if like any other human being. There are things that were supposed to have brought some decisions in the life of Manoa. And this was supposed to have affected his judgmental. And Manoa could not stick out from the prayers. And he could still stand to his expectation. The first thing he was supposed to have said this. Maybe someone might have come to my wife and they organized this. Maybe my wife, she said this to keep the marriage. But Manoa, his focus was to believe that if God speaks, we'll see the results. Look how Manoa, when the angel appeared, to Manoa, he was just a man of God. And he was ready to treat him like a man of God. But the message that the man was speaking to Manoa was very important. He never judged it wrong. This makes me to go to the scriptures, especially in Hebrews 13. If you read from verse 1 to 3, the Bible talks about we must not judge people because there are others who even entertain the angels. Our problem is we always judge. The problem is we always judge. Can you read Hebrews 13, 1 to 3, Mama?
Hebrews 13, verse 1 to 3.
Just read there.
Let love of your fellow believer continue. Do not neglect to extend hospitality to strangers, especially among the family of believers. Being friendly,
especially just
among the family of believers.
The family of believers.
Being friendly,
they're friendly,
cordial, and gracious, sharing the comforts of your home and doing your part generously. For by this some have entertained the angels without knowing it. Remember those who are in prison. And if you were their fellow prisoner and those who are mistreated, since you also are in the body and subject to physical suffering.
I want to tell you that one of the problems that Christians are having is to judge one another. And judging one another without information. judging one another without any message from above.
O atulela na osina leka taba ya mulaicha o thali wudimu.
Here the Bible says, remember.
Mo Bible rehopalang.
There are others who entertain.
Na le baba wai leba eleba khatisha.
The angels without knowing them.
O abatabisha barongo basatzevi.
Many people you don't need.
Batwa banchiwa usabatoke.
Are the ones who are holding your answers.
Ki bona baka ba tsweringi di petulo cha.
Can you tell about many people you don't need?
Batwa banchiwa usabatoke.
Are the one who are holding your answers.
Ki bona baba tsweringi di petulo cha how.
Judging to us affect us in a way that we can miss everything that God is organizing for
us.
I want to show you what judging does. Why we are not supposed to judge, number one. We can fail to receive the plan of God. Number two, we can lie to justify ourselves. Or we can lie to justify the false. Judging can block your responsibility. Because many things you see, which you judge, you are the one to correct them. Can you tell
them
about many things you see, which you know they are wrong, you are the one to correct them. Unfortunately, it affects our responsibility. One of the reasons why many of us fail in our assignment in life is because we judge other people in a wrong way. And judging them, it makes us now to build a wall that we cannot break and go to them. Sometimes you can find people that have to help you tomorrow. And you find that you have got a problem and they are the only one who have got a solution. Even in marriage, people are judging each other every day. You find someone is hiding from his responsibility, trying to expose another one's responsibility. Because what you want to do is to make sure that that one is wrong than you. When the Bible says, judge not, God is happy when we have got a free spirit. God is happy when we have got a free spirit. God is happy when we have got a free spirit. Also, already we know that judging, it also brings judgment to us. If you judge others, you might be in truth. If not, you are also judged because you are doing the same thing you are saying they are doing. I found that that's the only thing that makes us not to discern the truth, not to understand visitation, to locate our destiny. One of our challenges today is we found ourselves trying to find a way out. But most of the time, we feel like we can reach there by oppressing others. That's what I say, my friend. Stop judging other people. Because God doesn't want that. In John 8:15, Jesus was speaking. He says, you judge according to human standards. Just by what you see. No, just by what you see. I do not judge anyone. That was Jesus was speaking. You know, not long I was reading 1 Corinthians 5. It was saying, we Christians, we must judge each other. But it was talking about those who are sexually immorality. We need to take them aside so that we move on. But here the Bible says, it was Jesus who was saying, I don't even judge anyone. And when I judge, it's not because of what I see. Can you see, most of the time, things that we see are making us to be false insiders.
Le abana ga ntshililo tse re di bona ngi tsona tsa o di yong re be ba phoso ka hare.
Because we cannot see beyond on what we see.
Ka hore a re sa gona o bona go fitisha dintho tse re di bona ka matho.
The way we judge today,
ka mo gore a tholang le gono,
our sight, our spiritual sight,
o affecta matho a rena a se moya.
And this makes us to intermingle in the flesh.
And I don't repakatakanya dilo na meng, re fetse nako.
Holding things in the flesh.
Re tshwere dilo tsa mona meng.
Most of us who are here,
ba ba ntshira ba le mo. Reduching mo.
You are here because you judge someone.
Le mo ka ru ile wa thola motho mongwe.
This is the time that you can clear your mind.
Ye ke nako mana pa ya lo wena o ntshedilo ka o fela pelong le mopulong.
Only Jesus will reign.
O bona re ke Jesus fela ya bo shanka pelong ya gao.
If you can see that verse Jesus said,
how ka le mo wa bala verse la Jesus ore.
I do not judge anyone.
Na ke ga thole motho.
And you people, you judge according to human standards.
Ele le na le ga thola ka moemo bo bogato ba batho.
When somebody is not working, is not a person to you.
Ah motho a sa shume a se motho mo go wena.
If a person doesn't have money, it's not anything to you.
Ah motho a sa tshele tora ra bo le selo mo go
wena. You respect people who have got things of the world.
O thompa fela batho ba bana le dilo tsa lefaseleno.
Listen, the Bible says, others entertain angels.
Ba bangwe ba ile ba gathisha ba rungwa.
Can you remember when Jesus said?
Le go pela Jesu are.
That in the last day,
matachinga bofelo
people will say, hey, we didn't see
you.
He says what you have done to those little ones, because whatever the question that it will be questioned is coming from the responsibility we have been given, which was required and we failed because we are looking outside than inside.
Ka ba ne re thola kudukudu ka nte o fetisha ka hare.
I pray that today God will give you a spirit of blessing.
Na ke rapela re motimo ta re fa moya wa go nolekula.
So that you will never talk about other people.
O ro se ka ba go bolela ka motimo
ngwe. You love everybody.
O rata motho ka mohu.
He who does not judge, he loves everyone. That's what Jesus was saying.
Ndwe je so nai bolela.
You judge according to human standards.
O ale a thula le lebeletse go batho ba batho. Ka dintho tse le
bonao. Because you don't have love.
Ka le bakala gore le rato a le
yo. I love, I don't judge anyone.
Na ke na le rato.
If you read Isaiah 11 verse 3, he says he will delight, meaning Jesus will delight
Jesus
in the fear of the Lord, and he will not judge by what he sees or hears. He will delight in the fear of the Lord. I was learning these things not long. When devil wants to cage us, you know, he allows some wrong people around us to have negatives against us. So that the fear of God will diminish. When the fear of the Lord is in you, the first thing will be, God is watching me. I must do what he
says.
But when the devil wants to cage us, there will be some people who will rise around us to affect the fear of the Lord in us. And from there, we began to talk about them. We began to think about them. And we forget, the Bible says, meditate about the word day and night, and your way will prosper. That's where we find ourselves being blocked all the time. Let's stop judging each other. Let's begin to love each other. Let's begin to pray for one another. Listen, a church that judges others is a church that is judged already. A church that judges others is a church that is judged already. When you are judged, you have to judge others so that you feel you are one with them. This is the time whereby you look at yourself and say, I don't want to judge, I fear God. I leave everything to God. If you read John 7:24, the Bible says, do not judge by appearance,
Bible rose ka hathola ka ponagalo ne
and righteous
mara o yo hathole ka tuko.
Listen here, judgment here is the truth.
Hathola wa thola mona ki thiresho.
Fairly and righteously is truth.
Wo ra hore ka thiresho.
Listen, when you take a decision, stand in the truth.
Judgment
of yours must base in truth.
So,
but don't judge if you don't know the truth. Tell
somebody,
my friend.
Do not
judge if you do not know the truth. Don't talk about other people if you don't know anything about that. Listen. If you want to know about any container, go to those who created it. They will tell you. They will tell you what makes that container. Listen to this. Look at
Manoah.
What he did. When he heard that the man came, and the man said there will be a son, he didn't say, "You are lying." He said, "Let me ask and dedicate this to God. Let me pray than to judge anyone." And the prayer was, "God, if it's you, bring the same visitation." Look what happened when the wife came back and
say,
"That man is back. I see Manoah running behind his wife. Sometimes when you run behind your wife, people question you.
There are times you must run behind your wife.
Came to the wife, but because of that, ran behind the one who got the visitation. And when he was running, he never passed his wife. He just heard the man is here. He never undermined the wife. I could see the love the man was giving to his wife. Where he could not judge his wife. And when he reached there, he began to ask questions. Are you the man? Are you the man? Are you the man? If you are the man, how will we know? How can we bless you? Many times when we judge by our appearance. Manoah was supposed to have reached there and said, "You are not an angel. Where are the wings? You are not an angel. When I look at you, you are not Jesus. I mean, if you are Jesus, you must be like this. I pray today that visitation that God wants to do with you and to give you, you must never lose it by judging wrongly. There are some people who are coming your way and you are judging them. You are missing. You are blessing. Remember the scripture that God will never bless you except through them. Your blessing is in them. So if you judge everyone, you will miss every blessing. Can I tell you this? Today, God wants to use me to bless you. Stop judging me. Today, God is lifting you. He's lifting you. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Don't look at my appearance. Don't look at my appearance. See Jesus behind me. We need to reach a level where we have got eyes to see, so that we stand in the truth without judging people. Listen to this. Many of our problems are coming from our judgment. Can you see where you are? The stagnation, especially the spirit of limitation. When you speak against that one, you get limitation. I don't know if you are hearing me. Let me show another one. If you read John 8,
from 3 to 11,
I want us to read that verse, Mama. You
will
see what was happening there. You see this woman, that these guys who were holy than thou, catching the woman to Jesus. Just read, Mama, there.
Verse 3.
Yes.
Now the scribes and Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery. They made her stand in the center of the court. And they said to him, "Teacher, this woman has been caught in the very act of adultery. Now in the law of Moses, command us to stone such woman to death."
Stop there. I want to ask this question. I've been reading about you. I know you have been reading about it. My question was, Why these people, they could not judge themselves before they go take this woman there?
Why but Baba Sate had to love one appeal before Bacham Mauba Sipilale?
Because many of them were doing what this woman was doing.
Mama Nchin Nebanjiba idea and dream Sadio Naidia.
And why, I'm saying why?
Can you why, Malatu?
How can you get somebody on a very act?
You know, Mutumu, Huechabiani, Adira Mudiro.
Why, how can you do it alone?
Tabaye Libilena, we dear Viani Vian Udiliti.
How, if I was Jesus, I would just say,
even Nana Gilichi, some Tomona get a witchakari.
You can't this person with another one. And they will say, we go with, I say, please, I will judge it when you bring that other one. But Jesus here was interested in them. That they are busy accusing other people.
Whereas
they are busy with their own things. Can you just speak that in Pedi again? Speak that in Zulu.
Hey. Babeke kakhulu indaba yalomfazi ngapha nabo abanazabo indaba.
Speak that again. Mama speak all of it. Speak that in Zulu.
Babeke kakhulu indaba zalomfazi ngapha bona banezabo indaba.
Can you speak that in Afrikaans? Hey. I will stop there. Because I want you to know.
First.
You people here, one of our problems. If we just look what is happening in your head.
Is
2% about you?
98%
about other people.
98%
when are you going to live your life? Even the hairstyle you are having today is not even yours. It's not coming from your mind.
Everything
around you, nothing is 2%.
2%
but 98% about other people.
98%.
Can you speak that in Afrikaans, that statement?
It will be difficult.
Yeah, just say it. Altate.
And ye cake ni op your own manere.
Andiva?
Eh? Ye cake net op aner menses manere and ye cake ni op your own. Your own manner. Your own manners.
You will never go to heaven
because
of stories of other people. Your own manner. If you want to see that Satan has conquered you, before you pray, when you are busy praying, you will see stories running out in and out your mind. What you need to do from today, before you even pray, crush everything before you talk. Crush everything, ask God for forgiveness. Remove that judgment. You are not in a position to judge anybody. Because how can you judge someone when you are failing to judge your head? How can you judge someone? You are failing to judge your hair.
Kama upalo hatola ya
tho. You are failing to comb your hair.
Upalo ku kama mireri ya tho ya ha.
Other people's hair.
Kunya ko kama mireri ya ditho cha
batho ba bang. You are failing to wear your skirt.
Upalo apara sikete sa dula
botsi.
O ka bolela jwang ka sikete sa
motho mongwe. Upalo
ka o rapela.
You talk about Christianity.
Why do you go bolela ka di papulo swa batho ba
bang? You are failing to get married.
Wena upalelwa ke o nyalwa
ngwanesh. Why are you accusing?
Why wena upala batho ba bang molato ba ba le ka ramanya
ba bona. Deal with your story.
Shumana leta ba cha.
Deal with your problem. Deal with your challenge.
Hey,
you have got a big way in front of you. Don't ignore it. There's a big farm in front of you. Don't ignore it. Deal with it. Deal with it. Take away the weeds. Remove. Begin to prepare the soil. Bring irrigation. Take a seed. Focus on yourself. Deal with yourself from today. Stop judging other people. You are failing on your own. You are wasting your time. The time of looking on someone. This is the time of dealing with yourself. I don't know if you are hearing me. In Luke 18. From 9 to 14. You know the scripture. The man who entered the church. And he said, I'm the one who's supposed to be blessed. I'm the one who's supposed to be MC. I'm the one who's supposed to be intercessor. Not this one. This one is not even fit. And that one said, I don't want even to come close there. I don't want to judge anybody. I know my ways are not right. And Jesus said, who went home with a blessing? It was happening in the temple. Somebody said, you know, I'm a member of charis. I tithe all the time. No one can tell me. Even madala. When I come madala.
I interpret it madala.
I come madala or my fikizolo.
It does not work. You have come yesterday of his been long been here.
We are new creatures. All of us, we are new creatures. The moment when the Bible says you are new creation, it means the past is gone. Every day you wake up your salvation. You cannot reach a level whereby you judge others. I've been tithing. If you do that, you never tithe. If you talk about what you have been doing, you have never done that. Because whatever you have done does not give credit to yourself. It gives credit to the Father. There is someone who's ticking, who's approving. Listen, you must never judge yourself and judge others and look at yourself and give yourself preferences. You know what has happened to our churches today? It's preferences. You see, I look myself fit to accept that when I'm here, I feel like if I don't come to church, there will be no church. Have you ever found some people like that? Where they judge others as small. And compete themselves by others. What kind of spirit is that? If you love them, you will humble yourself and God will lift you up. I don't know if you are hearing me. Pastor will say, hey, I don't want to judge you. I want to love you. I want to love you. And as I want to love you, I believe God will use me to bless you. Tell your neighbor that. Do you know why we read about Jonah
while we're like? Why we read about John running away? Jonah.
It was because of hatred. He knew that Samaritans were enemies with Israel. I mean, look what happened. Where someone built his own wall by judging. And God said, now I'm sending you to Samaria. To Syria.
Go
there. go there and preach in Nineveh and preach the word of God.
You say, me,
those people have been oppressing us. I can't go there. I'm going to
Tarshish.
Many people today, they don't know that the oppression they got to blindfold them on the assignment that God is giving them. Sometimes people hate you so that you must feel intimidated not to reach them. Just clear that from your heart. Be a blessing, and God of mercy will raise you to reach them in the name of Jesus. If you believe, shout hallelujah. You must reach to a church, you feel small. When you reach the church, you just feel small. You feel that you need God more. Don't look at someone and say, why that one is sitting there? Why that one is sitting there? Why that one there? You reach to church, you say, hey, I'm here for the salvation of my soul. And as I'm here, whatever that distracts my way, I remove it. I can't beg any friendship that will take me away from God. But I won't judge anybody wrongly. I know my way, and I'm finished. We need Christians to say, I know my way. Do you know why we are judging each other? Because most of the time, we are born with this spirit of superiority. You are born with the spirit. That's why our schools, they put a system in us here. Number one, number two, number three. When we are going to school, many number ones were going to school. Many of them are not even educated now. Because of number one, number two, number three. They began to judge others. They know nothing. But others come at the back. And they end up becoming number one in the future. But as those number one in the beginning, judging others, they are useless. Many times when we are born, we end up having some pride. Everybody has been born with a little pride of looking others down. I don't know if you're hearing me. Stop judging other people. Say, I won't judge anybody. I just love my Jesus. I won't judge anybody. I love my Jesus. We are limiting ourselves. Even when somebody is having something, he might have stolen. If we can get a billionaire now here, all of you run to him to get money. Not to learn how to be a billionaire. You leave everybody. This is the time of embracing each other and pray for one another. This is the time of not fighting one another. If we are Christians, we will be one. We will be one. Say someone here who's listening to me. I said, God is giving you assignment. Those who were hating you, God will open their eyes. They are coming to ask forgiveness. Don't judge them. Forgive them. Love them. And pray for them. Because it is their time for them to see who are you in the Lord. They will know. And they are coming. And don't be afraid. I see them coming to you in the name of Jesus. Many of us, we have got many problems. Let me show you the scripture. If we read John 8:12-16, when I read this scripture, I was very, very worried. I read this scripture, I found, in fact, we are bound to be lost or misled because of a lack of wisdom.
Twelve.
Yes.
Once more Jesus addressed the crowd. He said, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in the darkness, but will have the light of life.
Carry on to 16.
Then the Pharisees told him, you are testifying of your own on your own behalf. Your testimony is not valid. Jesus replied, even if I do testify on my own behalf, my testimony is valid Because I know where I came from and where I am going, but you do not know where I come from or where I am going. You judge according to human standards, just by what you see. I do not judge anyone, but even if I do judge, my judgment is true and my decision is right, for I am not alone in making it, but I and the Father who sent me make the same judgment.
I want us to look at this verse. Even when I judge, that was Jesus saying, even when I judge, I judge in truth, because I'm not alone. I got a revelation from the Father. You know, remember I say, I do not judge. But even when I judge, there's some people, when you look at them, you just say, this one, maybe they are laughing, you are coming. You just say they are talking about you. You know, always, because you know your weak point. You think these people are talking about you. No free mind. No free mind. Jesus said, even when I judge, I judge in truth. Here we are talking about judgment. Because he says, I got revelation from the Father. Whatever I say, whatever I stand for, is the revelation that I got from the Father. This is the prayer we need to pray today. Because you need to judge. But when you judge, it must be coming from the Father God. I don't know if you're hearing me. That's what my friend. When you think, you think, you know. You need to check them from the Word. You need to check them from the Father. So that you must not sin against the Holy Spirit. I don't know if you are hearing me. Let me just try to tell you some things. Maybe it will help you when you leave here. I was telling my visitors yesterday, I said, how you face challenges shows how far you are going. How you face challenges. Some people who come to our lives to bring challenges to us, they are assisting us to where we are going. Most of the time, we end up judging them. No, it's their nature. It's their nature. They have to be like that. Unfortunately, they are in our atmosphere. They are in our presence. But it must not distract your vision and affect your focus. Sometimes there are people that you never change. Even if you pray, or you fight them, or you beat them, even if you speak with them many ways, you will never change them. They are just there to help you to your destiny. I don't know if you are hearing me. If you hold your peace and you don't judge, you just enjoy prayer, you'll be surprised you are there. I don't know if you are hearing me. Sometimes, you know, Satan will just bring people to crush you. Or others come not to help you. Others just come to disappoint you. Don't say anything. Don't judge them. Very soon, God will show up. I don't know if you're hearing me. You don't need them to where you are going. That is why they will do what they are doing. Because what you need to know, if you ask your Father God, like what Jesus is saying, you'll be surprised of the revelation. You'll be surprised that God might be teaching you one, two, three. I want to speak with someone who's listening to me, that God must give you a heart to forgive. A heart to forgive. A heart to forget. As you are facing all, don't judge. Keep quiet. Allow your heart to have the word as you are meditating that way. Bring joy in your heart by the word of God. Very soon, you will see something.
Very soon, you will see something.
If you believe, shout hallelujah.